In this video, I'm going to show you how to remove a background from an image using GIMP when you have a pretty much a solid colored background for the most part, not a lot of color variation. Keep in mind that not all methods of removing backgrounds will work in all circumstances, so you're going to want to learn different ones for different pictures. Most people will often just remove the background using the Fuzzy Select tool and just be done with it. But that'll often leave behind a slight border, which can be visible depending on what background you put that image in front of. I'll show you how to clean that up as well. If the edges of the image are well defined, then this is obviously much easier. The first thing we're going to want to do is add an alpha channel. So we're going to right click on the image, go into the layer menu, and then into this transparency submenu and select add alpha channel. Then I often create two other new layers, a black one and a white one. This just helps with finding extra pixels after you remove the background. You want to remove those to below your artwork layer, and then I usually just disable them to start off with. Next, we'll select the Fuzzy Select tool. If you don't see it, you may need to press and hold the mouse button on the Select by Color, if that's the one that's showing there, or you can press the letter U for the shortcut for the Fuzzy Select tool. Now, for settings in the Fuzzy Select tool, depending on your goal, you may or may not want to feather edges. For my purpose, I don't want any partially transparent pixels, so I'm not feathering the edges. The other setting that you want to be aware of is actually the threshold setting. I usually start off with 20. Sometimes I'll go up to 30 or even 40. This tells it how closely to select other colors compared to the one that you actually click on. So that way, if there's ones that are slightly white or off-white, it can select those as well as the one that you select. Now, first you want to make sure you're working on the correct layer, so make sure the artwork layer is selected. We're going to use the Fuzzy Select tool to then click on the background color we want to remove here, the white. Now you'll see over on the right-hand side under the selection editor, all the white areas are what are selected. You'll see it didn't fully select the white completely, so we can adjust the threshold over here a little bit. And we're going to try to see if we can get it to grab more of that. You can see it grab more at that point. Still not what we wanted, so we're going to adjust it a little bit more. And it, of course, grabbed more. Now, the other option is just to select a more middle color, like what I just did there. And as you can see, it selected it all. Now, we want to select the other colors. So the thing we're going to want to do now at this point is add any more areas to the selection is we're going to want to hold down the Shift key and click on more areas that we want to add. So for us, we're going to add the blue areas. So we're going to start clicking on each blue area and then until we have all the areas selected that we want to select. And once we're ready to remove it, we'll hit the delete key, which clears the background. And then I'll go up and unselect everything so we can see the results. Now, at this point, it's hard to see sometimes with the transparency layer. So that's where we're going to want to start using those additional layers so we can actually see these lines much easier. So we'll just go down here and enable them. So as you can see, once we enable the black, we can now actually easily see any of the leftover pixels that we're going to need to clean up. It's actually pretty easy to do. We're not going to actually have to go through and actually clean up most of those. So one of the first things I'm going to do is actually go in and clean up any of the bigger chunks left behind because we want to get rid of those first. So I'm going to select those, remove those. And sometimes these are a little tricky to get exactly what you want. That's when you usually want to adjust the threshold to try to grab the colors that you want to get. If it's leaving behind one or two pixels, that actually will get cleaned up the edges once on our next step. So I usually don't worry about getting exactly what I need at this point. And so I'll adjust that threshold until I find what I want, and then I'll remove that spot. Now, once we removed all the large chunks, we're ready to move on to the next step. On the artwork layer, we're going to right-click, choose Alpha to Selection. Now, depending on the size of your image, it could take a few seconds before everything's selected. Now, once you see everything selected with the little trails And on the right, you'll see all the white is what's selected, which is basically all the pixels. So those are all now selected. What we're going to do next is go up into the Select menu and choose Shrink. Now, usually I'm just going to use 2 or 3 pixels depending, but you can adjust that depending on the size of your image. 1 or 2 may be enough. Once I've chosen that, you'll see that move inwards a little bit, which is what we want. Now in the Select menu, we're going to go in and choose Invert. So now we're actually selecting everything else. And then we're going to hit Delete or Clear. We're going to remove all that. And now if we select None, you'll see we now have none of those pixels left behind. And if we look at the edges, you see we have nice clear edges. Now sometimes you may actually have to go through and touch up some things at this point, but usually that'll clean up most everything. You'll have to go through and touch up any small areas. And now you're ready to export and save the image. And just remember, if you want to save the transparency, you want to save it as a PNG in most cases. And thanks for watching. Hopefully that helped you out. There are other methods. I'll be making probably another video or two of some of those other methods. But this one works pretty well for a lot of background removals that are not detailed backgrounds. Don't forget to hit the like button and have a good day.